Hello, Sandy here. Hope you're well. Well, I'm super well today and I feel really superb. So I really am superb. And please, I'm going to read to you Marks and Sparks information. I have a book which is quite a nice book, to say the least, on subject of the Marks and Sparks and my late grandfather on my late father's side sold dolls, as some of you may know, for Marks and Sparks. And I'm just going to read you a little bit of information from this book before I go popping out to Poundland. I fancy treating myself, I don't mind saying. So here we go. Marks and Spencer, 1884 to 1984. A Sedentary History by Asa Briggs, with an introduction by Lord CF of Brimpton, M&S. This history of Marks and Spencer is published to celebrate the company's first 100 years. It is a unique, nostalgic record in words and pictures of a fascinating, often dramatic story of struggle and change. It begins on a trestle table in a Leeds open market and ends with a business that is, without exaggeration, a household name: M&S. The text, by the eminent social historian Asa Briggs, examines this unique organization in depth. In turn, he looks at the key aspects of the company's development, the influences that shaped its growth, the huge variety of goods sold, the constantly changing world of shops and shopping to which it has had to respond and adapt, the underlying philosophies that constitute its mainspring, and the people who have worked to create its success. Above all, it is a story about people. And in the preparation of this book, the author has collected the reminiscences of a multitude of those who have worked for, supplied, and known Marks and Spencer over the years. A mass of new information is recorded, and the hundreds of illustrations include many recent discovered historical documents. I hope you found that easy to understand and interesting. For now, I shall leave it at this point. I plan to do quite a bit more on Marks and Sparks, and really, it's in legacy of my late grandfather and my late father. I'm very proud. My late grandfather made a lot of money selling dolls for Marks and Sparks, and I'm saying it again because I'm adding that my late grandfather, I'm so proud of what my late grandfather achieved. And luckily, it's come down one generation, and my late father had a lot of, so to speak, assets, I think is the word. And so I'm really, really grateful and really, really proud of my family. And I want you to know that. And I do love my family very, very much. And my late father is with me all the time. I hope you like my makeup. If I may show you my clothing before I make a move. Thank you. It's fancied looking a little bit different today to my usual attire, I think one says. So I've got my nice satiny type of long cloak and my black sports bra with very nice, I like the material. It's very stretchy material, my top and then my bag. And then I have underneath, I have, if I can show you properly, my, no, I need to move this. Bear with me, please. I'm not the best photographer. Some of you, I think, know. So I have my lovely, lovely skirt and my usual shoes. and fancy socks. Well, thank you for watching me and hearing me, I hope. And please do take good care of yourselves and each other, please. I thank you so much. Again, take care, please. Bye-bye.